Hello students, I am Sachit Prakar. Welcome to Cars Physics. This is my lecture 1 on electric potential, which comes under the units electrostatics. Under electrostatics, as we have discussed, three subjects. The first subject is electric charge and electric field, and this is second one, electric potential. Okay, in this subject means in electric potential, we'll discuss electric potential due to, number one, a single charge, number two, a system of charges, number three, electric dipole. Okay, under electric potential we'll discuss electric potential due to a single charge, electric potential due to a system of charges, and electric potential due to an electric dipole. Okay, then we'll go to electric potential energy. Electric potential energy due to system of charges means we can't find electric potential energy due to a single charge. Electric potential energy due to a system of charges. Okay, and finally we'll describe about equipotential lines, equipotential surfaces, and equipotential regions. Okay, so first thing, to express electric field, to express electric field, we need, number one, electric field vector or electric potential. Okay, electric field can be expressed by using electric field vector or by using electric potential or potential difference. Okay, so all these things will be very clear after our discussion. Okay, so first our discussion is on electric potential in qualitative way. Okay, electric potential qualitative discussion. Qualitative discussion on electric potential. Okay, before going to electric potential, I like to recall you that you have already gone through gravitation. Okay, there you have gone through gravitational potential and gravitational potential energy. In similar way, here we will discuss electric potential and then electric potential energy. Okay, gravitational potential, electric potential. Okay, there are similar. And dissimilarities and similarities of electric field and gravitational field we have already discussed. Both the fields are conservative fields. Gravitational field is conservative field, or gravitational force is conservative force. Electric field is conservative field, and electric force is conservative force. So we have already discussed the characteristics of conservative force. Work done by conservative force is path independent. Work done by conservative force means work done by electric force is path independent. Okay, and number two characteristics, work done by conservative force in complete path is zero. Okay, suppose this is point A, this is point B. These two points are situated in an electric field. We'll take a charge from B to A. Either you may take along this path, or you may take along this path, or you may take along this path. Okay? 1, 2, 3. Okay? Work done is same. Because work done under the effect of electrostatic force is independent of path, only depends upon initial and final position. So path independent. Okay? Then work done in a complete path is zero. We have already discussed. Okay. But if you consider frictional force, we have already discussed in previous classes. Frictional force is a non-conservative force. If a body is displaced or moved from B to A in different paths, along different paths, under the effect of frictional force, then work done in different paths are different. Okay? But under electrostatic force, work done is same, since work done under the effect of electrostatic force is path independent. Okay? Then qualitative discussion. Suppose this is a body. Temperature of surrounding. Suppose this is a body. This is surrounding. Temperature of surrounding let 27 degrees centigrade, and temperature of body is also now 27 degrees centigrade. Okay, means temperature of the body is same as that of temperature of surrounding. Now heat is supplied to this body. Now heat is supplied. So as you know, if heat is supplied, then temperature, let initial temperature is 27 degrees centigrade. Now, temperature raised to let 40 degrees centigrade. Heat is supplied. So that temperature of the body rises. Can we say, if heat is supplied to a body, then heat in the body increases? Do you say it? If we supply heat to a body, can we say heat is increasing? No. We usually don't say like that. What we say? If heat is supplied to a body, then temperature increases. Okay? Suppose this is a beaker. This is water level inside the beaker. Let this height is H1. Density of water is rho. Density of any liquid, let's consider any liquid, density is rho. Then here pressure is P1, as we know, hydrostatics, fluid at rest, pressure is rho g H1. Now, some liquid is, drained into the same container, so that height becomes now H2. So pressure becomes P2, rho g H2. So, if fluid is given to a container, fluid means you may use liquid or gas. Suppose you blow a balloon. So that balloon, volume of the balloon means air inside the balloon. You blow air into the balloon and volume increases. So we blow air or we drain liquid into a container. We don't say that air is increasing or liquid is increasing. What is increasing? Pressure increases. Pressure. If fluid is given to a container, then pressure increases. If heat is given to a conductor or a body, then temperature rises. So, what we say? Temperature. Temperature is thermal condition of a body. Temperature is thermal condition of a body means heat or thermal energy is supplied to the body and we say temperature is increasing. Okay, next. Suppose this is a body, the body is A, and this is another body, this body is B. Okay, let temperature of this body is, temperature of the body is 80 degree centigrade and temperature of this body is, let 30 degree centigrade. Then obviously we say body A is hot as compared to body B. A is hot body, B is colder body as compared to body A. So temperature is thermal condition of a body. What temperature determines? Temperature determines the direction of flow of heat. Means now if these two bodies are brought into physical contact, now these two bodies are brought into physical contact, then heat flows from hot body, means which has high temperature, hot body to cold body, till their temperature becomes same. Okay, after some time common temperature will be established. The temperature is thermal condition of a body. Temperature determines direction of flow of heat. Heat flows from the body at high temperature to the body at low temperature. Okay, similar, let's consider two beakers. Okay, in this beaker, if height of liquid in both the beakers is same, this is H, this is also H, same height. Liquid is filled in two beakers, height of liquid is same. Now, if you join the two beakers by the help of a tube, then no flow of liquid. If temperature of two bodies same, then there will be no flow of heat. Here, height is same means pressure is same. Pressure is same. Since height is same, pressure is same. If pressure is same, then there is no flow of liquid or fluid. Say, now, this height is H1 and this height is H2. So pressure in this beaker due to liquid is P1, this is P2, and here P1 is greater than P2, so there will be flow of liquid. So greater the height of the liquid, greater is the pressure. So fluid flows from the region of high pressure to the region of low pressure. Heat flows from the region of high temperature to the region of low temperature. Fluid flows from the region of high pressure to the region of low pressure. Okay. Now we'll go to qualitative discussion of electric potential. If heat is given to a body, then we say temperature of the body is rising. If heat is supplied, temperature increases. If heat is supplied, temperature increases. Okay. If charge is given to a body, we don't say that charge is rising. If charge is given to a body, means charge is given to a neutral body becomes charged, then we don't say charge is increasing. What we say? Potential develops. Okay. So heat supplied, there will be change in temperature. Charge supplied to a body, there will be change in potential. Temperature determines direction of flow of heat. Potential determines direction of flow of charge. Pressure determines direction of flow of fluid. So, potential, qualitative discussion, electric potential. Is electric condition of a charged body. Electric potential is electric condition of a charged body. Number one. Number two. These are all qualitative discussion. Electric potential determines direction of flow of charge. Temperature determines direction of flow of heat. Potential determines direction of flow of charge. Okay. So, potential is called as electric pressure. Pressure determines direction of flow of fluid. Potential determines direction of flow of charge. So potential is also called as electric pressure. Okay. Electric potential is electrical condition. Electric potential determines direction of flow of charge. So potential or electric potential is called as electric pressure. So finally, I may write potential is analogous to pressure and temperature. Potential is comparable, potential is analogous to pressure of fluid and temperature due to supplied heat. So potential is comparable or potential is analogous to pressure and temperature. Okay. Potential is electric condition of a charged body. So you may take screenshot. Okay. Under this point, potential is electric potential is electrical condition of a charged body. So, number one, potential is positive due to positive charge. Potential is negative due to negative charge. Since potential is electric condition of a charged body, potential depends upon nature of charge. Potential depends upon nature of charge. If a body has positive charge, then potential is positive. If a body has a negative charge, then potential is negative. Okay. So, for a neutral body, neutral or uncharged body, potential is zero. For a neutral body or for an uncharged body, potential is zero, because neutral or uncharged means there is no resulting charge, so there is no resulting potential. Okay. Potential of neutral body is zero. Okay. See, suppose I do say my height is about 6 feet. My height is about 6 feet. Then where I do measure my height? From my feet. From my feet I measure my height. So I am standing on the ground, okay, floor of this house. So I do start measuring from my feet. So my feet is at zero. When I reached here, it is 6 feet. So reference point is at zero measurement. So to measure potential, we have to take a reference point. Of course, all these are based on assumption. To measure potential, we have to take a reference where potential is assumed to be zero. Usually, beyond electric field means at infinity. Potential is zero. This is assumption. Beyond electric field means at infinity, potential is taken to be zero. This is assumption. Number one. Number two, Earth is considered to be at zero potential. This is also assumption. Earth is considered to be at zero potential. What? So the practical thoughts we will discuss in later stage, but this is based on assumption. Earth is considered to be at zero potential or potential of Earth is taken to be zero. Potential of Earth is considered to be zero, or potential of Earth is taken to be zero. So how can we satisfy ourselves that Earth is at zero potential? The basic assumption is Earth is at zero potential. The cause is Earth is of very larger or longer radius. Radius of Earth is about 6400 kilometer. Okay, Earth is a huge resource of charge. Earth is a huge resource of charge. So any amount of charge, why Earth is considered to be at zero potential? Why Earth is considered to be at zero potential? Earth is considered to be at zero potential because any amount of charge given or taken away from Earth makes no difference in electrical condition of Earth. Why Earth is taken to be at zero potential? Earth is considered to be at zero potential because any amount of charge either given to Earth or taken away from Earth makes no difference in the electrical condition of Earth. So Earth is always considered to be at zero potential. This is our assumption. Okay. You may write it or you may take screenshot. Okay. Next point on Earth. Anybody in physical contact with Earth also attains zero potential. Earth is at zero potential. Earth is taken to be at zero potential. Not only that, anybody means any charged body, anybody in connection or contact with Earth, physical contact with Earth, also attains zero potential. How it becomes possible? Okay. Suppose these are three bodies, 1, 2, 3. Body A, body B, body C. body A is connected to earth. This is symbol of earthing. Body B is also connected to earth, and body C is also connected to earth. And it is observed that electrons are flowing from earth to body A. Electrons are flowing from body B to earth, and there is no flow of electrons. Then we have to say, what are nature of charges in the respected bodies? Electrons are flowing from earth to body A. Then what is potential of body A? Potential is electrical condition. Potential due to positive charge is positive. I have already written, potential due to positive charge is positive, potential due to negative charge is negative. Here electron is flowing from earth to the body, because this body, body A, has deficit of electrons. Body A has deficit of electron, means the body is, body A is, so body A is at positive potential. Means charge on the body A is now positive. A body is positively charged if it has lost some electrons or there is a deficit of electrons. Okay, so electrons flow from earth to the body to make it neutral. Suppose there are deficit of electrons, this charge is plus Q, which is equals to N. So N number of electrons are in deficit. So N number of electrons will flow from earth to body to make it neutral. Similar, for body B, electrons are flowing from body B to earth, means there is excess of electrons, so body B has excess of electrons, so it is at negative potential. And as we know, if a body has excess of electrons, then the body is negatively charged, so potential of the body is negative. Okay, here there is no flow of electrons either from the body or from the earth, so body C is at zero potential. There is no flow of electrons from either side, so body C is at zero potential, or body C is uncharged. Okay, if electrons flow from earth to the body, then the body is at positive potential. If electrons flow from body to earth, then the body is at negative potential. If there is no flow of electrons from either side, then the body is neutral. Okay, so this is about consideration of earth. Suppose these are two bodies, body A and body B. Okay, this body has positive charge, this body has negative charge, means here there is deficit of electrons, and here excess of electrons. Potential determines direction of flow of charge. If these two bodies now brought into contact, if these two bodies are now brought into contact, body A, body B. Body A is at positive potential, body B is at negative potential. So what happens actually? Electrons flow from body B to body A. Means electrons flow from the body as body at negative potential to the body at positive potential. So usually this body is at negative और लोअर पोटेंशियल, नेगेटिव पोटेंशियल और लोअर पोटेंशियल। दिस बॉडी हैज पॉजिटिव चार्ज, दिस हैज पॉजिटिव और हायर पोटेंशियल। सो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स फ्लो फ्रॉम द बॉडी एट लो पोटेंशियल टू द बॉडी एट हाई पोटेंशियल, बट कन्वेंशनली ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ अजम्पशन व्हाट वी से प्रोटॉन्स आर फ्लोइंग फ्रॉम बॉडी ए टू बॉडी बी। दिस इज कन्वेंशनल फ्लो, मीन्स इफ एन नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स दिस बॉडीज आर इन फिजिकल कॉन्टैक्ट और इलेक्ट्रॉन्स कैन नेवर फ्लो थ्रू एयर, इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एंड दीज आर प्रोटॉन्स। ओके, सो पोटेंशियल डिटरमिन्स डिरेक्शन ऑफ फ्लो ऑफ चार्ज। चार्ज फ्लोज फ्रॉम हाई पोटेंशियल टू लो पोटेंशियल, मीन्स प्रोटॉन इज फ्लोइंग फ्रॉम हाई पोटेंशियल टू लो पोटेंशियल। दिस इज अजम्पशन। ओके, प्रैक्टिकल थॉट इज इलेक्ट्रॉन्स फ्लो फ्रॉम लो पोटेंशियल टू हाई पोटेंशियल। द बॉडी बी इज एट लो पोटेंशियल, मीन्स नेगेटिवली चार्ज। बॉडी ए इज एट हाई पोटेंशियल, मीन्स ए इज पॉजिटिवली चार्ज। सो इफ टू बॉडीज आर ब्रॉट इन टू कॉन्टैक्ट, देन इलेक्ट्रॉन्स फ्लो फ्रॉम द बॉडी एट लो पोटेंशियल टू द बॉडी एट हाई पोटेंशियल। ओके, कन्वेंशनली ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ अजम्पशन वी डू से इक्वल नंबर ऑफ प्रोटॉन्स आर फ्लोइंग फ्रॉम द बॉडी एट हाई पोटेंशियल टू लो पोटेंशियल। सो आवर यूजुअल अजम्पशन चार्ज फ्लोज फ्रॉम हाई पोटेंशियल टू लो पोटेंशियल, दिस इज अजम्पशन। प्रैक्टिकली व्हाट हैपेंस, इलेक्ट्रॉन्स फ्लो फ्रॉम द बॉडी एट लो पोटेंशियल टू बॉडी एट हाई पोटेंशियल, बट वी डू अज्यूम द कन्वेंशनल फ्लो ऑफ चार्ज मीन्स पॉजिटिव चार्ज प्रोटॉन्स फ्लो फ्रॉम द बॉडी एट हाई पोटेंशियल टू द बॉडी एट लो पोटेंशियल। सो दिस इज अबाउट क्वालिटेटिव डेफिनेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल। देन वी गो टू क्वांटिटेटिव डिस्कशन। ओके, टू डिफाइन इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल इन क्वांटिटेटिव फॉर्म, फर्स्ट वी हैव टू डिफाइन इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस। ओके, फर्स्ट वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस, देन वी विल गो टू इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल। फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस, देन वी विल गो टू इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल। विदाउट डिफाइनिंग इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस, वी कांट डिफाइन इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल। विदाउट डिफाइनिंग इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस, वी कांट डिफाइन इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल। सो फर्स्ट वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड, फर्स्ट वी हैव टू डिफाइन इन क्वांटिटेटिव वे व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस। What is electric potential difference? Okay, electric potential difference, say this is a region of electric field. In the region of electric field, we do consider two points A and B. In an electric field, let's consider two points A and B. Okay, suppose the electric field is spread in this region, this is point B and this is point A. So how can we define electric potential difference? I am writing in complete form. It is defined as amount of work done in moving a test charge, and as we know, test charge means unit positive charge. Test charge, we do assume test charge is very, very small, okay, which is taken as unit positive charge. It is defined as amount of work done in moving a test charge from one point to another point, but external agency or external agent. Electric potential difference. Electric potential difference. Potential difference between two points is defined as. Electric potential difference between two points is defined as amount of work done in moving a test charge or unit positive charge from one point to another point by external agent. Okay. So, these are two points in an electric field. You may write down the definition, then I will erase it and discuss about electric potential difference. Okay. Can I erase it? Erase it? Okay. So, these are two points, A and B. Potential difference between any two points in an electric field is defined as amount of work done in moving a test charge by external agent from one point to another point. So, let's take B is initial position. A is final position. So, we do. Means in an electric field, suppose we place an unit positive charge or test charge. Okay. Then electric field will experience a force. Electric field will exert a force on it. Okay. Suppose the electric field is directed. This is the region of electric field. And as we know, electric field is directed from positive to negative or from high potential to low potential. So, this charge, test charge will experience a force in outward direction. Okay. In outward direction, this force is QE. So, here, this force is electrostatic force, let's take F electric. Electrostatic force is let along positive x-axis. Okay. So, we have to move the charge from one point to another point, from initial position to final position by the application of external agency or by the application of external force. So, I have to take this charge or you have to take this charge from position B to position A. Okay. Suppose this charge is moved from B to A. You may take along this path or you may take along this path or you may take along any path. Work done in electric field is independent of path. You may take along any path because electrostatic force is conservative force. Okay. Work done in moving a charge from initial position to final position or from one point to another point under the action of external agent. Okay. So, if this is electrostatic force along this direction, then this will be external force in opposite direction. Means we have to displace the charge or we have to move the charge from B to A. We have to apply an external agency which is opposite to the direction of electric force. Okay. Thus we will push the charge from one point to another point, but there is condition. We have to move the charge moving the test charge from initial to final position with or moving the tester slowly. What means slowly? Means we have to move the charge from B to A, from initial to final position. You may take any path. Work is independent of path. Okay? Slowly. What it means? Means speed or kinetic energy of the charge is constant. There shouldn't be change in speed or there shouldn't be change in kinetic energy. We have to move the charge slowly, means with uniform speed, or there will be no change, so that there will be no change in kinetic energy. We have to move the charge slowly. Okay. So with constant speed means electrostatic force, magnitude of electrostatic force must be equals to magnitude of external force or magnitude of force by external agency or external agent. Okay. So electric potential difference is amount of work done in moving a charge from one point to another point, from initial point to final point. Okay. With uniform speed or constant kinetic energy, or we may say slowly. Okay. So there shouldn't be change in kinetic energy while moving the charge from one position to another position. Okay. This is about potential difference. Okay. Potential. The symbol of electric potential, we do take V. Potential difference between these two points, V is initial, A is final. Final potential is VA. Initial potential is VB. Okay. So VA minus VB is potential difference. Potential difference. Potential difference is defined as amount of work done by external agency to move from B to A. Amount of work done by external agent to move from B to A per an unit positive charge or test charge. Amount of work done by external agent. Amount of work done by external agent to move the test charge from initial to final position. So potential difference is between two points. Potential difference between any two points in an electric field is work done by external agency. Work done by external agency. Work done by external agency to move from initial position to final position to an unit positive charge or test charge. Okay. So I may write it. You may write dV is equal to work done by external agent moving it from B to A per an unit charge or unit positive charge or test charge. This is about potential difference. Potential difference. Potential difference is equal to work done by external agent moving from B to A per unit positive charge. This is potential difference. Okay. Next, what we have discussed, to define electric potential, we have to first go through potential difference. This is potential difference. Okay. Amount of work done in moving a test charge from initial position to final position or from one point to another point in an electric field. Okay. Electric potential difference. Okay. Then in quantitative way, we'll discuss about electric potential. Electric potential. It may be hypothetical, but we do accept it. What we have discussed, My height is about 6 feet, but when I start measuring my height from my feet, measurement is zero, 0 to 6 feet. So reference potential is taken to be zero. Hypothetically, we have to assume potential at a point is zero. What I have discussed, the reference point is beyond the electric field or at infinity. So basic assumption to define electric potential, basic assumption, potential beyond electric field or at infinity is zero. Okay, so here potential difference from B to A, final potential V A, initial potential V B is equal to work done by external agent to move from B to A per unit positive charge or test charge. Okay, this is point A and this is point B. We have displaced a charge from B to A along any path from B to A. If B is at infinity, if the point B, position B is at infinity, then potential at B means potential at infinity may be taken to be zero. If we take VA minus V infinity is equal to work done by external agent moving the test charge from B to A per unit charge, then V infinity is zero, potential at infinity is zero. If potential at infinity is zero, then we may write here potential at position A is, potential at position A is work done by external agent in moving the charge from infinity to A per test charge. This is about potential at any point A, work done by external agent to move an unit charge from infinity to point A, potential at A. Okay, so electric potential, am I right? Can I erase all these? The electric potential at any point A in an electric field, potential at A, work done by external agent moving the charge from infinity to point A, moving a unit positive charge or test charge from infinity to point A, this is potential at point A. Our assumption is potential at infinity or beyond electric field is zero. Okay, this is about quantitative idea of electric potential, and we will derive expression for electric potential for a point charge or for an electric dipole in next lectures. Okay, finally I will write some points electric potential at point A, work done by external agent moving it from infinity to point A, what to move an unit positive charge, potential, electric potential is a scalar quantity. Electric potential is a scalar quantity. The test charge should be moved slowly with uniform speed or constant kinetic energy. Okay. Again, we have discussed the work is independent of path. Then we will go to units of potential or potential difference, same thing, units of potential, same as that of units of potential difference. Okay. Units. Units of potential, electric potential or potential difference. Units is in MKs or SI. Units is volt. We may write V. Work per unit positive charge. So work is in joule, charge is in coulomb. So how can we define 1 volt? Potential at a point is 1 volt. If work done by external agent in moving an unit charge of 1 coulomb from infinity to that given point, so that work done is 1 joule. 1 joule of work per unit charge of 1 coulomb is equals to potential 1 volt. So 1 volt is equal to 1 joule per coulomb. Dimensional formula for potential, I am writing V, work. M1 L2 T to the power minus 2 divided by charge. Charge is A to the power 1, T to the power 1, and M to the power 1, M to the power 1, L to the power 2, T to the power minus 3, A to the power minus 1, work by charge. This is dimensional formula. This is units in MKS or SI. Okay. I am erasing this dimensional formula. Okay. You may take screenshot. Then, in CGS, ESU, electrostatic unit, unit is start volt. 1 start volt in CGS, work is org, charge is start coulomb or ESU of charge. Okay. Then, CGS, EMU. We have already discussed in previous subject. Okay. Unit is absolute volt or half volt is equal to, in CGS work is org and this is EMU of charge or half coulomb, absolute coulomb charge. So these are different units in different systems of unit. And now conversion, you may write it. I will convert volt into start volt, volt into half volt. Okay. 1 volt is equal to 1 joule per coulomb. Okay. 1 volt. 1 joule, convert it into CGS. 10 to the power 7 org, and 1 coulomb is 3 into 10 to the power 9 ESU of charge. Then 1 volt is equal to 1 by 300 org per ESU of charge, means start volt. 1 volt is equals to 1 by 300 start volt. Okay. Then 1 volt is equal to 1 joule per coulomb. Again, 1 joule is 10 to the power 7 org, and 1 coulomb is 1 by 10 absolute coulomb or EMU of charge. Absolute coulomb or EMU of charge. Then 1 volt is equal to 10 to the power 8 org per absolute coulomb or org per EMU of charge is of absolute volt. Okay. 1 volt is 1 by 300 start volt. 1 volt is 10 to the power 8 into absolute volt and 10 to the power 8 half volt. Then this is 1 volt, this is 1 volt, we may equate. This is 1 volt and this is 1 volt. 1 by 300 start volt is equal to, or I may write like this, 1 by, this is start volt, this is absolute volt or half volt, this is 1 volt, this is 1 volt. So 1/300 start volt, this equals to 10^8 of volt. Finally, one start volt is equals to 300 × 10^8, 300 × 10^8 absolute volt or half volt means one start volt is equal to 3 × 10^10 half volt. This is final conversion. 1 volt, how much start volt? 1 volt, how much absolute volt? And 1 start volt is how much absolute volt? Okay, these are relations, and this class is electric potential means fundamental discussion, basic discussion on electric potential. And in this lecture, we have discussed on qualitative idea about electric potential and electric, and quantitative idea also about electric potential and electric potential difference. Okay, this is the end of lecture 1 on electric potential. In lecture 2, we will go to find how to derive expression for electric potential due to a point charge, okay, and electric potential difference. All mathematical derivations, we will do all the things starting from basic to applications. Okay, so basic discussion is useful for your school level studies and board level studies, and we will do some board level questions also, and finally we will access some application points which will be helpful for your competitive exams like NEET and JEE, etc. Thank you, students. Thank you for your sincere support. Thanks.